Mal kurz checken. Oh, I can do that.
Goofy motherfucker.
I hope you get ripped off again. 1,400 490 chicken.
Look, I can get some chicken, but I don't want to work for them.
Call the restaurant.
This is just making me crave it.
I don't crave anything that I have to pick up a phone and call for, you know?
What about pizza?
Who the fuck is that? Is that a homeless man?
Oh, I think we're in worse condition than the homeless man, homie.
Day one. Hello there, homeless Henry.
No, get back here. Huh?
Okay, a little bit weird.
Whoa. What kind of chicken place has a drive-thru?
What kind of chicken place is called fried chicken? Chat with the employee. He didn't mention his name was James.
Why does Chinatown have a capital of the world?
yeah, that's cool, Laura. I'm sorry that happened to you.
Back in the late 1800s, the small town of Gordonsville, Virginia, became known as the Fried Chicken Capital of the World. It celebrates this claim to fame by hosting an annual Fried Chicken Festival, usually on the third Saturday of May. Gordonsville's fame as the world's fried chicken capital can be traced back to the 1840s. Gordonsville benefited from the business and visitors that the Virginia Central Railroad and Alexandria Railroad brought into town. Following the Civil War, the railroad continued to shape Gordonsville identity. The town remained as a rail stop, even when ownership was transferred to the Chesapeake and Ohio Railroad. And the townsfolk of Gordonsville, specifically the women from Gordonsville African American community, saw an opportunity and seized it. That's when the chicken crossed the railroad. The women, who later became known as chicken vendors, would balance plates of fried chicken on their heads and serve the passengers by passing the fried chicken to them through open rail car windows. Even when passenger trains started using dining cars and no longer had food come in through the open windows. Out of memory, reload this page. The town of Gordonsville would have the chicken ready for the dining cars to pick up. When passenger trains no longer stop at Gordon's, there's a rifle in the freezer. There's just an assault rifle in here.
How many Robux does it cost?
124. What to expect at the chicken festival? While passenger trains no longer stop at Gordonsville, the town sought to commemorate its infamy as the chicken leg center of the universe by hosting an annual festival. The highlight of the festival is as a fried chicken cook-off, with the top three winners getting small cash prizes, along with bragging rights. But this small town festival in Central Virginia is not just about food. In 2017, Gordonsville added a 5K race to the festival so that visitors could burn some calories preemptively. After the festival, if you need to take a break from eating chicken, then check out the Civil War Museum in town.
Alright, let's play the game.
What was the point of that whole monologue?
I want to go to this place now.
Gordonsville?
Yeah.
Hey, clerk. It's the agent. I want to warn you about something real quick. Okay, what I want to warn you about is that there's some weird animal around here that's causing people to go missing. Just making sure that you're careful and safe for the evening. Yes.
Why would the FBI be warning about this? You know, the most interesting part so far with me monologuing. Also, you wanna know why I came across that?
Why?
I searched for places named fried chicken.
In what we're expecting?
To see if I can find any restaurant anywhere in the world that was called fried chicken.
What is our objective now?
I don't fucking know.
Oh.
Chicken.
Chicken. Goodbye.
Nice fellow. Uh-oh, what the fuck? Hello there. I see you got that plastic surgery.
Oh my god, Caleb. Co-op chitting.
I thought we were done with that game.
That's the other one. The women's room.
So, I've never personally been in the women's room, so I didn't realize that they did this.
This is the average KFC experience.
That's the experience of Kentucky Fried Pissing?
Oh, yes. Sorry. I'll have one of those big buckets.
Oh, he wants
Chef, a big bucket. Go get a big bucket.
I've got just the thing for you, my friend.
Thanks. Good night.
Sweet, sweet, sweet.
Why can't I just use my bare hands?
You got bare hands?
Take out the trash, four left. There's only three of us here.
What should I read and monologue out while we play?
The homeless man! Homeless Henry, I done told you. Here you go, you can read from this. Let me make sure I send this to the right person.
where are you going?
Huh? I didn't know why, I didn't read the dialogue, so I don't know what happened.
Cock and ball torture. CBT. 6.2. Involving the application of pain or constriction to the male genital. This may...
Hey, Devin. Reading this, can you filter out any time it says cock to chicken and male genitalia also to chicken? Any other relevant words you can think of to chicken? I think that'd be great.
Chicken and chicken torture is a chicken activity involving the application of pain or constriction to the male chicken. This may involve directly painful activities such as chicken piercing, wax play, chicken spanking, squeezing, chicken busting, chicken flogging, chicken play, tickle torture, chicken electrostimulation, kneeing or kicking. The recipient of such activity may receive direct physical pleasure via chickenism or emotional pleasure through chicken humiliation or knowledge that the play is pleasing to chicken cystic dominant. Many of these practices carry significant chicken risk. Similar to many other chicken activities, chicken torture can be performed using chicken and chicken to make the chicken and chicken more easily accessible for attack or for chicken play purposes. Chicken stretcher is a chicken toy used to elongate the chicken right up here. It's pulling the chicken away from the body. This can be particularly enjoyable for the wearer as it can make a chicken more intense as chicken is more prevented from moving up and tended to make one's chicken permanently hang much lower than before. This chicken toy can be potentially harmful to the chicken and the circulation of the blood can easily be cut off if over-tightened. A more dangerous type of chicken stretcher can be homemade by simply wrapping rope or string around one's chicken until it eventually stretched to the desired length. A chicken crusher is a device made from either metal or often clear acrylic that squeezes the chicken slowly by turning sets of nuts or screws.
I think I'm out
how
of here.
Tight it is depends on the chicken tolerance of the person is used on.
Oh, okay.
A chicken crusher is often combined with bond to children with a partner or by oneself, or with other types of torture or impact limb. Parachute is a small collar, usually made from leather. It's fastened around a chicken, and from which weights can be hung. It is conical in shape. Used as a part of chicken and chicken torture within the chicken relationship. The parachute provides a constant drag and a squeezing effect on the chicken. Humbler is a chicken physical restraint device, a chicken and chicken toy used to restrict the movement of a submissive participant. And a chicken scene. It consists of a chicken cuff device, typically a ring that clamps on the base of the chicken, which is drawn back between the legs. As a result, the wearer is forced to keep their legs folded forward, as any attempt to straighten them even slightly pulls hard on the chicken, causing anything considered discomfort to extreme pain. Please. In this way, the wearer is prevented from standing up straight and has to stay bent over or crawl on all fours. Chicken cuffs are one of many defenses used to restrain the chicken. A standard padlock, which cannot be removed without its key, may also be locked around the chicken. Some passive participants enjoying the feeling of being owned, while dominant individuals enjoy the sense of owning their partners. However, these are extreme uses of chicken cuffs. More conveniently, the device pulls down the chicken and keeps them there during stimulation, which has a number of benefits, making the chicken appear longer. Pulling the chicken down away from the base of the chicken stretches the skin over the base of the chicken and pubic bone, exposing additional few centimeters of chicken that is normally hidden from view.
You like to make sure that your chicken is in its coop.
I'm gonna cry.
Proving chicken, God. While some participants may be. chicken harness is a device to be worn around the chicken. It's something or some event of a chicken. Early chicken harnesses for use for chicken in a variety of ways. These devices were designed for medical use to prevent chicken while sleeping, which is believed to cause seminal weakness and other physical problems.
Wait a minute. What does that have to do with chickens?
The Gates of Hell is a male chicken device made up of multiple chicken breeds. It can be used for chicken.
Chicken. Because everything is just chicken.
Chicken busting is the practice of kicking or kneeing participants into chicken. It carries several medical risks, including the danger of chicken rupture from blunt trauma.
Uh-oh, everything's on fire.
Chicken!
Tom McCary is a chicken.
What?
And subgenre of chicken, which within a man's chicken, or then also refers to as chicken busting. Tamakeri is a Japanese term, but is used by many non-Japanese people to describe media where Asian people, mainly women, are participating in it. The dynamics of tamakeri consist of a chicken having their chicken hurt by a chicken. Huh?
What did I miss?
Denki Mana is a popular Japanese prank played between two people where one puts their foot into the chicken area of the other and shakes it in a vibrating motion. Often this is done by grabbing the other person's feet and raising them and placing one's own foot on their chicken and vibrating it. Mm-hmm. This is often done between school-age boys as a prank similar to Kancho and can be seen as a Western audience as a type of bullying. In 2006, Frito-Lay released a special
what?
Taitsuken-themed edition of Dorito chips that reference Denki Amna.
Designed after some sort of chicken torture method?
Safety. Loss of blood flow is the greatest risk in chicken and chicken torture. Chicken. The level of pain is not an indicator of a problem with signs of danger. And signs of danger include numbness or loss of color and edemas. Chicken in which the chicken are tied to another object is especially dangerous, increasing the risk of damaging the chicken through excessive tension or pulling. It's not about the journey, it's about the destination. Wait, no, it's the other way around. It's not about the destination, it's about the journey.
Are you enjoying the journey?
I just want the journey to be over, dude. I look more forward to the destination.
That's what they all say when the chicken starts getting tortured.
Calling the chicken.
Who's checking the chicken?
I'm checking the chicken.
Of course you would be.
Who's choking the chicken?
Not right
now. You abuse your chicken. Hi, it's a chicken from the chicken shop. There's something really chicken going on around chicken. Could you elaborate? What's going on? I don't chicken. I feel like I'm being chicken and...
What the fuck?
Chicken.
Chicken!
Chicken!
Shot that chicken dead. Oh, we gotta go through the door.
Bro, we gotta make like chickens and chicken.
We gotta let's get chicken.
That was chicken. Huh?
I saw that one coming. Survive until the. Oh, wait, fuck off. Come on now, really?
My man just got chicken.
Oh, teammate, revive me. Thank you.
You know what? I'm a big little goofy.
What do you mean?
Where's this?
How can you be goofier ship? Than you've already fucking been?
He bought the gun.
Oh, Devin, why?
He's stuck. Did you kill him?
Mm-hmm.
It's not counting down anymore.
Paid money to break the game.
Survive until the chicken arrive.
That's a real chicken tickler right there.
Now you never know what will happen when the chicken crosses the road, huh?